a day. I deserve a bay. And don't forget the flowers every anniversary. Cause if you treat me right, I'll be the perfect wife. Buying groceries, buying what you need. You got the 9 to 5, but baby, so do I. So don't be thinking I'll be home and making up the pies. I never learned to cook, but I can pride a hook. Sing along with me, sing along with me. Hey, you gotta know how to treat me like a lady. Even when I'm acting crazy, tell me everything's alright. Dear future husband, here's a few things.
Good morning, BHS.
And welcome to the 22nd episode of the Paw Print Newscast.
Hey guys, we had a lot of stuff going on this week.
Jared, it does seem like we did. Drew, can you tell us a little bit about that?
No guys, it was very eventful. And Monday, we had the annual blood drive. And Elijah has the scoop.
Thanks guys, I'm here at the blood drive that's held annually. It's been held at BHS for over 20 years. And I'm going to talk to a couple students. I'm here with sophomore Blake Tomlinson. Blake, what was it like just giving blood, and how are you feeling, and what would you recommend for people that might be a little bit scared to give blood?
It's not that bad as you think, and just make sure you eat a good breakfast, like really eat a good breakfast. Other than that, it's pretty easy.
How are you feeling right now?
Pretty good.
Well, there you have it. Go give some blood. Hi, I'm here with fellow community member and blood donator, Kathleen. Kathleen, is this your first time giving blood?
No, I've given probably 24 times now in the last few years.
Good thing you're doing. Also, what brought you out here today at BHS?
Well, I came here because when I give blood, I look for some place that's close. And also, both my granddaughters attend Bath, so I thought this was a perfect way to give blood and support Bath also.
Very nice, very nice. Also, one last thing here. What would you recommend to someone who might be a little scared of getting poked in the arm with a needle and donating blood to someone that may need it?
Well, I think it's great to give blood. I have no problems with it. And, you know, if somebody's a little anxious, there's nothing to be worried about. It's, you know, it's in fact, it's kind of a fun thing to do, and helping too also.
Thanks for the advice, Kathleen. Hope you have a nice day.
You too.
Thank you, Elijah, for getting that, and thank you for everyone who's out there donating.
Students, if you're interested in trying out for the Flag Corps next year, you have a meeting on March 6th after school in the high school band room.
All right, guys, if you missed this short clip on Wednesday brought to you by Interact about the eating disorders, be sure to check that out on our YouTube channel after you watch this.
You know, since you brought that up, Kennedy went out there and got an interview with Katie and for the...
That I did.
Good work.
I interviewed Katie, so out to that now. I'm here with Katie McNamara from Interact. Katie, can you tell us a little bit of what this poster is about?
Yeah, this poster is part of our Interact group's push this month to bring awareness to eating disorders. So it kind of shows how unrealistic a lot of societal expectations can be for body image and stuff like that. So like, for example, Barbie is proportioned so ridiculously that she would have to walk on all fours and wouldn't be able to lift her own head up.
Yeah, and how serious are eating disorders, and like how many people can they affect?
They can affect any kind of person. It's not just like an only a woman's problem or anything like that. It can be anyone of any age or body type or gender or anything like that. And they can be really deadly just by their own effects physiologically, but there's also a really high rate of suicide in people with eating disorders.
Yeah, and then what are some like prevention methods and some resources that are available?
Well, you can always go talk to your guidance counselor or another trusted teacher or something like that. But there's also like a helpline available and like an anonymous online chat thing on like myneda.org, so.
Thanks, Katie.
Thanks, pal, and thanks, Katie, for the valuable information.
Anytime.
If you plan on taking ACT April 8th, make sure you register by today.
Now, out to our student of the week, freshman
Cole Hammer.
She's falling in love now, losing control now, fighting the truth, trying to hide, but I think it's all right, girl.
What is good, guys? I am here with freshman, also student of the week, Cole Hammer. Cole, what are you mostly involved in here at BHS, and what are your favorite activities to do outside of school?
Well, the only thing that I'm really involved in, other than like my 7 classes, is baseball, really. That's pretty much it.
What position do you play?
I play all around, but I'm hoping to catch mostly this year.
Sounds pretty dope. Sounds like you're quite the utility player here.
Yes, sir.
Who are your best friends and who are your favorite teachers at BHS be?
Best friends would be Gage Imes, who's our center fielder. Austin Sagemiller, he plays infield and pitcher. And Logan Davis, he's also an infielder.
How about teachers?
Teachers. Mr. Stiles got to be one of my favorites. And Mr. Garland.
Sick. Well, there you have it. Cole Hammer, everybody. Student of the Week.
Falling in love now. Losing control now.
You know what's coming up soon?
Graduation?
Of course. Can't wait to graduate.
Neither can I. I just really need some decorations for my graduation party.
I have an idea. Just call Fultz.
You talk about their opinion doesn't count.
Fultz! Signs of all kinds. We have signs for sponsors, businesses, and graduation parties.
Yeah, cause I don't really know who I'ma lose this year. Oh, man, I love my team.
Make it, boy, we gotta make it. You can save your hand, I ain't gotta shake it. Everything lined up for the taking. And what I need from him, no favors. Click too big, break, gotta break it. Cause these others low key with the snake infecting. Everything lined up for the taking. And what I need from him, no favors.
Sports
is where
you currently are. Unfortunately, the boys basketball got defeated by Defiance 40-41. But congrats to Chad Fry for getting honorable mention in the WBL.
But the girls basketball team beat St. Mary's Saturday 48-38. But congratulations to Bailey Dakin for first team, Heidi for third team, and Jaden for honorable mention.
How about some wrestling, guys? Huge congrats to our two seniors, Trey Terry, Trey Beyond that is, and Isaac Ingram for getting their 100th wins in their wrestling careers at Bath High School. Also, our district qualifiers include Travion Terry, Isaac Ingram, Eric Adkins, Colin Mell. Congrats to you guys, and whoop some butt in districts. Now, out to our weather.
Girl from the south side, got braids in her hair. First time I seen her walk by, and I about fell off my chair. Had to get her number.
Na, na, na. Now for your weather. I'm here doing some weather with Mr. Willis McGahey. Willis, how are you?
I'm marvelous today. How about you?
Swell, Will. Swell. Where are we at?
We're in Ronald's truck again.
What piece of Ronald's truck?
The trunk. Nice.
I don't think there's trunks and trucks. Well, wonder what this marvelous piece is. It's some sort of a rack. It's all right. Now for the weather. Friday is going to be 38 and partly cloudy.
Saturday, it's going to be a whopping 53 degrees and partly cloudy.
And then on Sunday, we're going to rank it on up to 60 as it's going to be 60 and partly cloudy.
Yep, sounds pretty nice. Can't wait.
Where are we heading out to now, Will? Now we're heading out to the polls.
Ay, mama told me, ay, not to sell work. Mama 17-5, same color t-shirt, white. Mama told me, ay.
Hello, we are here with Jackson Barnes. Jackson, out of all the delicious Girl Scout cookies, what happens to be your favorite?
I'd have to say the Samoa.
Yeah, I think they changed the name, but I like those too.
Yes.
Hello, I'm here at TNX. Can you guys get in a little bit closer? Alright, on the count of three, you guys are both going to say your answers. What is your favorite Girl Scout cookie?
3, 2, 1.
Samoa.
Do you prefer colored pencils or crayons?
3, 2, 1.
Colored pencils.
Your favorite color in 3, 2, 1.
Purple.
I think this speaks for itself. Thank you.
I'm here with Tion and Jenica. Do you guys prefer waffles or pancakes?
Waffles.
Waffles.
All right. Good answers. Thank you.
I'm here with Courtney Gross. If you could time travel, would you go to the past or the future?
I'd probably go to the future.
You know what?
Gotta see that technology, man.
There it is.
Mallory, waffles or pancakes?
Pancakes.
All right. White or brown rice?
Brown.
Colored pencils or crayons?
Colored pencils.
Sharpies or Crayola markers?
Crayola markers.
Cash or credit?
Cash.
Steak or chicken?
Steak.
All right, thank you.
I'm here with Jonah. If you could time travel, would you go to the past or the future?
Future.
Why?
Because I want to go to the past.
There it is. With Heidi, the lunch lady. Heidi, since you are such a lunch fanatic, where would your number one place be to eat lunch at in Lima?
I would say Texas Roadhouse.
Texas-y.
I'm here with Austin and Cohen. If you guys could time travel, would you go to the past or the future?
That's hard. I'd go to the future.
Why?
Well, things might be better.
Okay, what about you?
I would go to the past.
You know why?
Just to see older cars. I love cars.
Me too, man.
Hi, we are here with Colleen Schaefer. Colleen, I have a couple of questions for you. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, first, bowl or burrito?
Bowl.
Nice. Now, steak, chicken, the weird vegetable one?
Steak and chicken.
Oh, both. Very nice. Now, rice, white or brown?
Brown.
Nice, nice and healthy. Beans or no beans?
No beans.
Guacamole?
No.
All right, I think that's like
$12. Yeah, pretty much.
All right, cool. Hello, I am here with Logan Schaefer in the blue corner, Hunter Imes in the red corner. With a combined, we have 200 pounds. And guys, I have a quick question for you. Liberty or Wrangler?
Libby, for sure.
Now, Hunter, what about you?
Accord.
Very nice.
I can be a lifesaver. Treat me like a jawbreaker. You got 31 flavors, baby. You can get this now.
Hamburger pickle on top makes your heart go flippity flop.
Have you had your Cupid today?
That song, the one that makes me go all night long, the one that makes me think of you. That's all you gotta do.
Thank you for watching the 22nd episode of the Paw Print Newscast.
We have a few things that we'd like to pass along to you before we wrap up our newscast.
The academic team had two teams compete in the Bath Invite, and they placed third and fifth.
Kennedy had a chance to speak to the academic team regarding their Bath and Rice Day invites this week.
I'm here with Mr. Grimm, the coach of the academic team. I heard you guys recently won a competition, so can you tell us a little bit about that?
Sure, we'd be glad to. I'm just showing the plaque here real quick and put that down in a second there. Second time in 3 years, by the way, that we won this competition, so that speaks well of the students there.
Nice.
We went to Rice State Lake campus yesterday for their annual Scholastic Bowl tournament, which they have during their spring break. And we were able to, you know, have a great day and win it. They play four teams at once, and you try to win your round and win points. So we were able to get a lead, and the team was able to hang on for a victory.
Yeah, that's great. Congrats to the academic team.
Hey, Kennedy, seniors, you have the opportunity to tour PNG.
Yes, the tour will be on March 15th from quarter after 9 to quarter after 11.
On March 21st, all juniors would be taking the ACT. Therefore, freshmen, sophomores, and seniors don't have to come to school.
Hey, we got no school on the 21st?
Yep, only the juniors have to come to school that day.
Students, remember, the third quarter ends on March 17th.
Be sure you're working to keep your grades up.
And juniors, if you have any interest in becoming the leader of leaders, the Marine office should be your route.
Sergeant Barnett will be here to talk about the Naval Reserve Officer Training Scholarship.
He will speak about how you have the chance to get $150,000 for college education.
And if this interests you, you should explore if you have what it takes to become the few, the proud, the Marines.
Thank you for watching this episode of the Paw Print Newscast.
Have a great day, BHS.
Hey, Mr. DJ, when you gonna spin it? My baby's favorite record, she been waiting for me. She invited all the friends, and I'm buying all the rounds, and they're all DJ, please don't let me down. When you gonna play that song? When you gonna earn that pay? When you gonna play that song and make my day? She said, play that song.
With 40 to 41.
It's
but congrats.
You said
you currently are. Not we currently. Sorry, sorry, you got it.
No, you say that part.
I forgive you.
You say
you are forgiven.
Did I hear him say that?
Get out of here. Yes, she's
looking
out. Yes.
I did.
I know.
You can't say that. Sorry.
Go.
By defiance, 40 to 41. But congrats to Chad Fry for getting honorable mention. I don't know what that means.
Ready? Welcome to the weather. I'm here with Big Willis McGahee. Willis, how are you?
I am pretty good.
Get food in my mouth.
Adula Ablinkata.
Hello, I am here with Logan Shit. I already messed up.